فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we were in the sharh of the kitab جلباب المرأة المسلمة في الكتاب والسنة written by الإمام محمد ناصر الدين الألباني رحمه الله. We previously were in the speech of الإمام ابن جرير الطبري and what ابن جرير الطبري said. We took the biography of Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. We also spoke about the statement that he said in his tafsir. We were in the middle of that, and we'll finish that bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. So Ibn Jarir al-Tabari went on to say, and after he brought the hadith, and we weakened the hadith of Asma, he said, فَإِذَا كَانَ ذَلِكَ مِنْ جَمِيعِهِمْ إِجْمَاعًا. So if you remember, what he was talking about was that all of the ulama are unanimously in agreement, by consent, okay, that the woman's awrah in the salah. They agree that the awrah of the woman in the salah, what it is. And they all wholeheartedly agree that أَنَّ لِلْمَرْأَةِ أَن تَكْشِفَ وَجْهَهَا وَكَفَّيْهَا فِي صَلَاتِهَا. That the woman is allowed to show her face and she's allowed to show her hands if she's in the prayer. So he's saying this is something they all agree upon. All of the ulama agree upon it. Then he says, فَإِذَا كَانَ ذَلِكَ, if the matter is like that, مِنْ جَمِيعِهِمْ, from all of the parties, إِجْمَعًا, by consent. And we remember we mentioned that the term إِجْمَع, what Ibn Jarir al-Tabari means by it. We said Ibn Jarir doesn't care if three people are on one side and the rest of the ulama are on the other side. For him, this is called a what? And it's called an ijma'. For him, this is called a, it's called an ijma', a consent. He then says, فَإِذَا كَانَ ذَلِكَ مِنْ جَمِيعٍ إِجْمَاعًا كَانَ مَعْلُومًا بِذَلِكَ أَنَّ لَهَا أَن تُبْدِيَ مِنْ بَدَنِهَا مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ عَوْرَهُ كَمَا ذَلِكَ لِلرِّجَالِ. So if that is the case, and it is permitted for her to show it, her hands and her face, then لم يكن عورة كما ذلك للرجال. Then it would not be عورة for her, just like it's not for the men. In the prayer, if she's allowed to show her hands and her face, okay, and it's allowed, and this is not an عورة in the salah, then Ibn Jarir al-Tabari said, just the same way it's not an عورة for her in the salah, it's not also for the men, and the men are allowed to show it outside, and so is she allowed to show it outside. لِأَنَّ مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ عَوْرَةً فَغَيْرُ حَرَامٍ إِظْهَارُهُ. Because whatever is not an awrah, then it is what? It is not haram for you to show it. For you to show it. وَإِذَا كَانَ لَهَا إِظْهَارُ ذَلِكَ. And if it is then permissible for her to show that, كَانَ مَعْلُومًا أَنَّهُ مِمَّا اسْتَثْنَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Then now it should become clear that this is from the things that Allah has exception. It's from the things that are exception. ذِكْرُهُ بِقَوْلِهِ إِلَّا مَا ظَهْرَ مِنْهَا. That which is an exception in this ayah, Surah An-Nur, إِلَّا مَا ظَهْرَ مِنْهَا. لِأَنَّ كُلَّ ذَلِكَ ظَاهِرٌ مِنْهَا. Because all of that, which is her two hands and her face, are apparent from her. Here we have to have a waqfa before we go to the kalam of Sheikh Al-Allama Al-Albani rahimahullah, which is that Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, this great Mufassir, is using the awrah of the prayer to say what her awrah is outside the prayer. This is what his argument is, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari rahimahullah. And this is something you tend to find many people fall into. Many people, they fall into something which is awrah to salah, the awrah of a woman in the prayer, وَعَوْرَةُ السَّتْرِ وَالنَّظَرِ. The awra that is present in the woman when she's in the prayer, and the awra with the woman when the men want to see her. We need to distinguish between the two. Because of this, there's a khaltun kathirin min al-kuttabi wa mimman allafa fi hadha al-mawdu'. Many people who have written this topic, who have authored works in this, tried to speak against the niqab or whatnot, there's a lot of the times this issue, this khalt happens from them. The prayer for the men, as it has come, hadith, like Bukhari and Muslim both are narrated, Bukhari and Muslim, for the men. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لا يصلين أحدكم, that one of you should not pray في الثوب الواحد, he should not pray in one garment, ليس على عاتقه شيء, which there's nothing on his shoulders. So the man in the salah, he's not allowed to pray unless there's something on his shoulders. So the scholars, they differed within themselves. الحد الذي تبطل صلاة الرجل بكشفه له. What amount if the man shows in the prayer would nullify his prayer? Scholars differ on it. And the majority of the ulama, the jumhur, the majority, the overwhelming majority of the scholars are that the awra is ما بين السرة إلى الركبة. That the awra of a man, generally speaking, is between his what? From his navel to his knees. But then look at the prayer. The ruling of the prayer is totally different. The salah, the man has to have something on his shoulders. Because the prayer has something khas. As for the woman, on the other hand, the prayer, something specific has come for her, which is, لا يقبل الله صلاة حائض إلا بخمار. As for the salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that Allah will not accept the prayer of a woman who has reached her menses unless she prays with a khimar. So the salah has a what? Ahkamun khasatun. Has specific ruling that are specific to it. That the man and the woman needs to observe. Hajj. There are ahkam which are specific to it and clothing which are specific to it that men and women have to observe. You can't wear normal clothes now. That which was permissible for you now, you can't wear it. You have to wear a specific type of clothes, oh man. And oh you woman, you have to specifically dress in a specific way. You're not allowed to, as a woman what? You're not allowed to show, what do you call it? You're not allowed to show your face, you're not allowed to, sorry, put a niqab on, or put gloves on. This is what is the matter. So many people, they see books of fuqaha, the jurists, they read a book from the kibarul fuqaha. And this fuqaha will mention when they're talking about the woman's clothing in the prayer, they will say, al-mar'atu awratun illa wajhaha wa kaffayha. That the woman is a awra except her face and her hands. And so they say, look at the fuqaha, look at the jurists. This is what they said, that the woman's face and hands are not awra. And they transmit that so many times. But they are having a problem here. These ulama are talking about her, libasul mar'ati, the clothing of the woman in what? Fi salati, in the prayer. In the prayer. Not the ahkam of looking at a woman on the streets. And when the woman is outside the prayer. This is not. So we have to distinguish between awratun nadari, the awra of looking at a woman outside, who's outside looking at her, wa awratu salati wa sitri, and the awra of a woman covering and placing a veil over herself while she's praying or covering up. ولذلك some of the fuqaha, they mentioned from the madahib al-arba'a that the woman, her awra in the prayer and her awra outside the prayer is different. Let's look at the statement of Al-Khatib Al-Shirbini. Al-Khatib Al-Shirbini, rahimahullah, is from the Fuqaha al-Shafi'iyya. He has a kitab called Al-Iqna' fi halli al-fadhi Abi Shuja'. Madn Abi Shuja' that we're going to study, he has a sharah on it. Al-Khatib Al-Shirbini has a sharah on it. From the great Fuqaha al-Shafi'iyya. He says, إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ بِحَضْرَةٍ أَجْنَبِيٍّ فَلَا يَجُوزُ لَهَا رَفْعُ النِّقَابِ. Al-Khatib al-Shirbini in the small book of Matnabi Shuja' that we study every Wednesday, he says that the face of the woman and the hand of the woman in the prayer first of all is what? Is not a awra in the prayer, meaning she doesn't have to cover it in the prayer. The woman doesn't have to cover it. But he said, إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ بِحَضْرَةٍ أَجْنَبِي. That if the woman is in a gathering where there are men, the woman is in a place where there are men, she's praying, and there are other ajanib that are there that might see her. In this situation, فَلَا يَجُوزُ لَهَا رَفْعُ النِّقَابِ. It is not permissible for her to lift her niqab. The reason is because the ahkam of salati and the satr, the ahkam of the prayer, are you with me, has now become, and the ahkam and nadar, the ahkam of the woman being looked at outside, those two when they come together, which one takes more superiority, which one takes more, what takes more is awratul nadari, the awra of the woman being looked at. That takes, and there are many ulama from different madahibs. For example, من المالكية اللخمي, from the great أئمة المالكية, من الحنابلة, from the scholars of the حنابلة, شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله, and others, from the حنفية, الإمام الطحاوي رحمه الله. So for the four madhabs, they have علماء who stated the same. شافعية, we have الخطيب الشربيني, and others, many others. We have in the حنف المالكية, we have اللخمي. We have in the حنابلة ابن تيمية. We have in the Hanafiyya al-Imam al-Tahawi rahimahullah. So it is important and it's necessary that a person distinguishes between what? He distinguishes between awratul mar'ati fi salati, the awra of the woman in the prayer, and the awra of the woman in what? The awra of the woman in the nadari, when the man wants to look at the woman. We need to distinguish. ولذلك even Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah in the kitab, he even points that out. He doesn't agree with Ibn Jarir al-Tabari's understanding. Sheikh Albani rahimahullah. Look at what Sheikh Nasir says after that. Sheikh Nasir says, وَهَذَا التَّرْجِيحُ. This view that Ibn Jarir has taken and strengthened, غَيْرُ قَوِيٍّ عِنْدِي. It's not strong according to me. Albani saying this. How Ibn Jarir al-Tabari is mixed up. Ahkam al-Salati wa-Satri. And the Ahkam al-Nadari, how he's mixed the two up. Sheikh Albani said, وَهَذَا التَّرْجِيحُ. That strengthening of the opinion. غَيْرُ قَوِيٍّ عِنْدِي. It is not strong according to me. Pay attention here. Albani, look at the honesty and the sincerity and the justice here. Ibn Jarir, what he's saying, affirms Sheikh Nasir's opinion, his ultimate view, which is that the woman's face and her hands is not awra. Lakin, even then, Sheikh Albani doesn't just take everybody who pushes any argument to support that. He wants to take the opinions that to him are the strongest. And this shows the insaf, the justice, and the fairness on the Sheikh's side. Rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a. He says, لِأَنَّهُ غَيْرُ مُتَبَادِرٍ مِنَ الْآيَةِ. Because what you take from the ayah, this is not what rushes to you straight away. Mutabadir means what comes to the mind first when you read the verse. In other words, the zahir of the ayah, the apparent essence of the verse does not show that. عَلَى الْأُسْلُوبِ الْقُرْآنِيُّ. In the form and the layout of the verse. وَإِنَّمَا هُوَ تَرْجِيحُ بِإِلْزَامِ الْفِقْهِ. He said, what you're doing, O Ibn Jarir, and the way you're strengthening this, is you're forcing, you're imposing a fiqh opinion. It's not what you took from the ayah. Meaning the way you said that, this is the salah, and this is that, all of this is a fiqh preconceived notion, basically. وَهُوَ غَيْرُ لَازِمٍ هُنَا. And this fiqh observation of yours is also not غَيْرُ لَازِمٍ هُنَا. It is not necessary here. I mean, it doesn't apply here. لِأَنَّ لِلْمُخَالِفِ. Because those who oppose the niqab, who believe that niqab is not wajib. So who believe that niqab is wajib, sorry. Who believe that a woman should cover her face. Those who have that opinion. فَإِنَّ لِلْمُخَالِفِ أَنْ يَقُولَ. He can say, جَوَازُ كَشْفِ الْمَرْأَةِ عَنْ وَجْهِهَا فِي الصَّلَاةِ أَمْرٌ خَاصٌ بِالصَّلَاةِ. They can respond that the permissibility of the woman showing her face in the prayer is a specific matter for the prayer. أمر خاص بالصلاة. That's what they can argue. فلا يجوز. They can carry on saying it is then not permissible أن يقاس عليه كشف خارج الصلاة. You can then not try to use the awra in the salah for outside the salah. لوضوح الفرق بين الحالتين, because of how clear the two situations are different. This is Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah ta'ala trying to prove and trying to elaborate on that what we mentioned. What we just mentioned, Sheikh Nasir also pushes that. That there are is two different situations. The salah is different from outside the salah. Good. Then he goes on to say, أقول I say, me Albani, هذا مع عدم مخالفتنا له. Even then, I don't oppose Ibn Jarir al-Tabari في جواز كشف وجهها وكفيها. I don't oppose Albani, I don't oppose Ibn Jarir in the permissibility of showing the woman's face and the hands. وكفيها, and her hands. في الصلاة وخارجها. في الصلاة وخارجها. I don't oppose him that it's permissible for a woman to show her face and her hands in the prayer and outside the prayer. I don't differ with him on that. I'm with him on that, Sheikh Nasir is saying. We here agree on the prayer. We believe that the woman in the prayer, she's allowed to show her face and her hands. Are we all together? But بحضرتي أجنبي, if there is a present, a man who's a foreigner, what does she have to do? She has to cover her face. This is where again, Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah ta'ala later is going to use that and argue on that point against us. Also, we differ with Sheikh Nasir on this issue of what? Alayhi rahmatullahi, we differ with him on the issue of the awrah of the woman outside. When the woman is walking outside, the awrah and what she can show, the hand and the face. We differ with him on it. Rahimahullahu ta'ala. So here we learn a qa'ida, brothers and sisters, which is, just because you agree with a person in the ultimate goal, that doesn't necessarily mean you would agree with them in the means. Just because I agree with you in something, the ultimate goal, I agree with you, the final solution, the final result, that doesn't necessarily mean that I what? I agree with you in the means to take, and the way to bring that about. And that's a reality we live today. Many Muslims will say, I want to bring solution for the Muslim. I want to bring the victory that the Muslim have lost. That is then something we're going to say to them. We want to bring the falah of the ummah, fi dunya wal akhirah. We're with you on that. But the means that you're taking and the way that you're trying to bring that about is where we differ. We don't differ in any way, form or shape that the honor of Islam, the honor of the Muslims, the needs to be returned. The la yashuku fi ithnan min al-muslimin. Two Muslims don't differ on that. But we differ on what? How should that be brought back? Some would say the way to bring that back is by politically being engaged, by being in politics. That's how we bring it about. That's one group. Another group, they believe the way to bring back the honor Muslims have lost is jihad. Take your guns and fight. Kill anyone who comes in front of you. That's one group of people. Another group of people, they hold that the way to bring back the honor of Muslims is by purification, the cultivation, at-tasfiyah wa tarbiyah, that the Muslims are cultivated correctly and that they are purified from the filth that have connected to their belief, the shirk that some of them have taken on board, the bid'ah, the innovation that some of them have taken on board, the sins that the Muslims have taken normally, the eating of riba and drinking of khamar. So those are the groups. Sahih? So we take the view that the way to bring back the honor of Islam and the Muslims is by at-tasfiyah wa tarbiyah. That's the path for it. And that's how the Prophet did it. And that's how the evidence is proved. And that's how the textual proofs are with. May Allah make us those who take that path. So Sheikh Albani says, أقول هذا, I say this, مع عدم مخالفتنا, even that though we don't oppose, I don't oppose, في جواز كشفها ووجه, في كشف وجهها وكفيها في الصلاة وخارجها, that I don't differ with Sheikh Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, that it's permissible to show the woman's face and also to show her hands in the prayer and outside the prayer. وقف here. Albani has imposed now that Ibn Jarir believes that the woman can show her hand and her. What did we say last lesson? We said, لا. Ibn Jarir, when he was commenting on Surah An-Nur, إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, this verse was the first verse that came down regarding the hijab. We need to look at the last verse that came down regarding the hijab, which was the ayah, ayah 59, I think, Surah Al-Hazam, where Allah says, يَا يَا النَّبِيُّ قُلْ لِأَزْوَاجِكَ وَبَنَاتِكَ وَنِسَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يُدِنِينَ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ جَلَابِيبِهِنَّ ذَلِكَ أَدْنَى أَن يُعْرَفْنَ فَلَا يُؤْذَيْنَ. This ayah, Ibn Jarir al-Tabri's commentary is talking about the last, is talking about the what? The last verse that came down. So when he's talking here, he's going to be speaking about the last verse as it has come down. And he proves Ibn Jarir al-Tabri in that verse that the woman should cover her face, rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a, and she should cover her hands. We brought that last lesson. So Sheikh al-Bani says, we agree with Ibn Jarir al-Tabri on this view. لِدَلِيلٍ, but we agree with him based on evidences. بَلْ لِأَدِلَّةٍ, Sheikh al-Bani goes, rather, evidences. Not evidence, evidences. So we don't use this ilzam fiqhi, that you're necessitating, you're imposing your fiqh opinion here. Now, we hold this opinion, why a woman's face can be shown and a woman's hands can be shown, we believe it's permissible, لِدَلِيلٍ, based on evidences. Then he says, بَلْ rather. لأدلة evidences أخرى, many other evidences غير هذه, other than what Ibn Jarir mentioned, كما سيأتي بيانه, as it's going to clearly come forward. We're going to bring it to you guys, and inshallah when he brings it we'll respond to each one inshallah ta'ala. We'll bring what he's trying to get from it and then the response for it inshallah ta'ala. وإنما المناقشة, but the discussion is هنا here في صحة هذا الدليل بخصوصه. Before, Sheikh Al-Bani say, we have many evidences to prove that a woman's face can show. We have many evidences that the woman can show her hands. Al-Bani saying, and inshallah ta'ala, they're going to come. Clearly, you're all going to see it. But the discussion at hand here is, sihati hadha al-dalil. Is it correct to use this evidence? Specifically, illa ma zahara minha. We're not talking about the claim that Ibn Jarir is claiming here, that the woman's face and her hands can be shown. That we agree upon, Ibn Jarir. Where you were differing on this particular evidence at hand, using it in this way. فَالْحَقُّ فِي مَعْنَى هَذَا الْإِسْتِنْبَاطِ مَا أَسْلَفْنَا أَوَّلَ الْبَاحْتِ. Sheikh Al-Bani said, the truth and the correct observation on this verse, إِلَّا مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا, فَالْحَقُّ, the correct way is, and the correct understanding of that verse is, هذا الاستثناء ما أسلفناه, that which we have previously mentioned. أول البحث, at the beginning of our writing. وأيدناه, we supported our view, بكلام ابن كثير, the statement of ابن كثير. ويؤيده أيضا, and somebody else supports me here. كما في أيضا ما في تفسير القرطبي, الإمام القرطبي in his tafsir. He also supports me. So Al-Bani saying, even I agree with Ibn Jarir al-Tabari في صحة دعواه, that which he has claimed that the woman's face and her hands can be shown, I agree with him on that. But here, صحة هذا الدليل, the way he's using إلا ما ظهر منها, I don't agree with him on that. Al-Bani said, I agree of what I mentioned previously. We spoke about what he said previously, the kalam of Ibn Kathir and how he used it. Now inshallah ta'ala, we're going to quickly touch on who is Imam al-Qurtubi. We hear about Imam al-Qurtubi a lot. Who is he and what is his tafsir like? His name is Al-Imam Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Abi Bakr ibn Farh. So you have to place bi iskan al-ra'i wal ha'il muhmala. So you say bi farh. There's a sukun on the ra. Al-Ansari, he's from Ansar. Al-Khazraji, he's a Khazraji. Al-Andalusi al-Qurtubi, he's from Andalusi and Spain, modern day Spain today. Huh? The ism is Al-Imam Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Abi Bakr ibn Farh. That's his name. بِإِسْكَانِ الرَّاءِ وَالْحَاءِ الْمُهْمَلَةِ الْأَنْصَارِيُّ الْخَزْرَجِيُّ الْأَنْدُلُسِيُّ الْقُرْطُبِيُّ. He was from what? He's Ansari. He's from the people of Ansar. Ansar were two big tribes, right? Al-Aws and Khazraj. He's from what? He's from Khazraj. He's from Spain, modern day Spain today, sah? Andalusia. Okay? And he's from Andalusia, was very big. Granada, Qurtuba, many places. Ishbil, many places came under it. Are we all together? He was from? He's Qurtubi, he's from Qurtuba. When he was born, the scholars of his biography don't tend to mention it. Lakin, the muhakkik of the kitab At-Tadhkir, At-Tidhkar, fi afdal al-adhkar, the muhakkik of that kitab, his name is Bashir Uyun. He gives a year to it. And he said he was born the year when it was 600. Al-Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah, he grew up in Andalus. And it was at the time when the Asr al-Muwahideen, the Asr of the era of the Muwahideen, so people you need to look into. Asr al-Muwahideen. It was a dawla that stood up in Maghrib on the hand of Muhammad ibn Tumart, who died in 524. And he took over, of course, Dawlatul Murabitin fil Maghrib wal Andalus. That was the time he, rahimahullah, and Imam al-Qurtubi, rahimahullah, was at that particular time. He remained and he stayed there, rahimahullah, until it fell with the hands of the Franja. When it was the year 633 Hijriya, and he moved to Egypt and he stayed there, rahimahullah, hatta atatu al-baliyya, until death came to him. Andalus and Qurtuba at that time was known as Muntah al-Ghaya. It was the ultimate goal. It was where everybody wanted to go to. Markaz al-Raya, the flag and the banner was up there. It was Ummul Qura. It was the mother of all towns and cities. Ahlul Fadli wal Taqwa, the people of virtue, the people of piety were there. Ahlul Ilm wal Nuha, people of knowledge and understanding were there. Civilization. Sciences were being taught. The ulama, you hear many scholars who are called Qurtubi. He, rahimahullah, he lived in that time. ولذلك, if a scholar died, for example, it said that إِنَّهُ إِذَا مَاتَ عَالِمٌ بِإِشْبِيلِيَةٍ. If a scholar died in Ishbilia, which is part of Andalus, فَأُرِيدَ بَيْعَ كُتُبِي, and he wanted to sell his books, حَمَلَتْ إِلَى قُرْطُبَةِ, it will be taken to Qurtuba حَتَّى تُبَعَ فِيهَا, so it can be sold. It's the knowledge of the people where they will buy it straight away. So he was grew up in that kind of environment. رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ رَحْمَةً وَاسِعَةً. Imam al-Qurtubi, rahimahullah, he became very known for, from a very young age, rahimahullah, he was very well known for his love for knowledge. He had jawdatul fahmi. His understanding was very strong. وَقُوَّةُ فِي النَّشَاطِ الذِّهْنِي. His mindset was very enthusiastic and was very, mashallah, sharp. He encountered and he came in contact with many different sciences, many different ulum, rahimahullah ta'ala. ولذلك الإمام الذهبي says about him, إمام متقن. He says about him, he's an imam who's mutqin, grounded. متبحر في العلم. He's متبحر, he's a sea in knowledge. له تصانيف مفيدة. He has many beneficial books. تدل على إمامته, that shows his how he, that he's an imam. وَكَثَرَتُ اطِّلَاعِهِ. And it shows that this man has read a lot, Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi rahimahullah. وَوُفُورِ فَضْلِهِ. How great his virtue is, rahimahullah ta'ala. Ibn al-Imad, he said about him, كَانَ إِمَامًا عَالِيمًا غَوَّاسًا مِنَ الْغَوَّاسِينَ عَلَى مَعَانِ الْحَدِيثِ. He said he was an imam, alim. He was a what? غواص. عالم الغواص من الغواصين. He was those who dipped deep in the not understanding of hadith. حسن التصنيف. Good authorship. جيد النقل. Good at transmitting things. رحمه الله. Ibn Farhun, he said about him, كان من عباد الله الصالحين. That Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi was from the great worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والعلماء العارفين الورعين الزاهدين في الدنيا. And he was from the scholars who were wari', they were wari'een, meaning they would stay from doubt, stay away from doubtful issues. Al-Zahideen, who were aesthetic in this world, they turned away from this dunya and abandoned it. Al-Mashghulina, those who busied themselves, bima yu'inuhum min umur al-akhirah, those who busied themselves with whatever will help them to the hereafter. Awqatu ma'bura. And Imam Al-Qurtubi's time was full. It was fully complete. It was filled up with khayr and good. ما بين توجه وعبادة وتصنيف. It was all between a time which he's teaching, a time he's worshipping Allah, and a time he's authoring. That's it. That's his time. It was all divided well for him. رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. لذلك, that's the value of a scholar, a person of knowledge. They value their time. Wallahi, anyone who doesn't value their time, are they going to value your time? Somebody who doesn't value his time, will he value your time? La. Al-Imam Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, he said, I saw a group of people who sit around, they do nothing. Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, he said, I saw a group of people who sit around, they do nothing. They don't stand up to do anything, they waste their time. And he said, I looked at my own time, my own particular time. I observed my own time, how my time is. And he said, I realized that my time is so tight. I get so much time wasted. So I said, I calculated where my wasting of time goes. And he said, I realized it is based on sharpening my pencils, getting my papers ready. That takes time from me. So he said, I went to those people who waste their time. I said, come here. I got a good job for you. Sharpen my pencils for me. Order my paper for me. That's it. And he said, I realized that so much time was towards good and khayr that I could do. So if you know people who waste their time, who don't do nothing, all day just sitting somewhere, you can always benefit from them. You can what? A lot of people today, what they say is that you are a what? What do they say? That the human is a what? It's a حيوان ناطق. صح, they say human is a... It's a animal, what do they say? Huh? Scientifically, they say we're speaking animals, right? In Arabic, they say that. We're حيوان ناطق. In other words, humans are animals. Huh? We don't believe that, shara'an, that the human is a haywan al-natiq. We believe that the human is what? As Hassan al-Basri said, you are time. إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ أَيَّامٌ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ سَعَاتٌ. Your hours that came together. It's just hours that came together. That's what made you, right? What's the difference between you 10 years ago and now? Time. That's all it is. So you're just time that came together is what made you. So if you don't value your own essence and what you are, if you don't value it, then what kind of khayr would you have? Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi rahimahullah had many shuyukhs that he took knowledge from. Rahimahullah, and he met them and he took knowledge from them. From his most prominent scholars that he took from is his Shaykh Abu al-Abbas Al-Qurtubi. From one of his famous shuyukhs that he took from is Al-Imam Abu al-Abbas Al-Qurtubi. The author of the Kitab Al-Mufhim Lima Ashkala Fi Sahih Muslim is the teacher of who? The teacher of the Mufassir, Al-Imam Abu al-Abdillah Al-Qurtubi is his teacher. He took a lot of knowledge from him, rahimahullah wa rahmatan wasi'ah. He also took from al-Shaykh Abu Ja'far Ahmad ibn Muhammad al-Qaysiyu, who's very well known as Ibn Abi Hajjah from Ahl Qurtuba. He took from him, rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'a. He also took from Ibn Ubay, Rabi' ibn Ahmad ibn Rabi' al-Ashwiyu, min Ahl Qurtuba, and he was a qadi, kana rajulan salihan. He also took from al-Qadi, Abu al-Hasan Ali ibn Qatran, وهو أبو الحسن علي بن عبد الله بن محمد الأنصاري القرطبي فقيه مالكي. الإمام القرطبي رحمه الله. It would be nice if somebody one time or if we took time out to speak about his book, his tafsir and the methodology that he took. One of the greatest books that he's left behind, الإمام القرطبي رحمه الله, is his tafsir. And also what he left behind is what? His kitab al-Tadhkira fi dhikri ahwali al-mawta wa umur al-akhirah. A book where he speaks about the matters pertaining to the hereafter. Al-Imam al-Qurtubi. He wrote that book. Rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'a. And he has other works as well. And as we said before, his works are profound and they are amazing. So Imam al-Qurtubi, rahimahullah, he says, قال ابن عطية. Again, who's ابن عطية? So Imam al-Qurtubi brings the statement of Imam ibn عطية. Who is ibn عطية? Ibn عطية is علم الفد, the great noble imam. أحد أشهر علماء الغرب الإسلامي. From one of the greatest ulama that came from the West. Imam Ibn Atiyya rahimahullah, his name is Abu Muhammad Abdul Haqq ibn Ghalib ibn Atiyya al-Gharnatiyy al-Andalusi. He was born the year 481. Abu Muhammad Abdul Haqq ibn Ghalib ibn Atiyya al-Gharnatiyy al-Andalusi. And then look, he's from Gharnata and he's from Qurtuba. All of these are all under Andalus. He was born the year 481 in Gharnata. He grew up in a house, fi bayt ilmin wa fadlin. He grew up in a house where knowledge and virtue was there. Mundu nash'atihi, the day he was born. Ponder on this. Any alim, you read their biography, generally speaking, you rarely hear them saying that he grew up in a house where music was listened to and haram was being committed. La. What you hear is that they grew up in a bay'ah, fi bayti ilmin wa fadlin. They grew up in a house of knowledge, a house of virtue. That's what you will come across. So if you want a child to become a next alim, and you want him to be a scholar, what do you have to keep in mind? That you'll have to build that kind of environment for him. You need to make that kind of atmosphere for him. You need to. You need to set that up for your children so they can become scholars, so they can be people of knowledge. منذ توجه إلى طلب العلم متأثرا بالروح العلمي. Imam Ibn Atiyya rahimahullah, he turned towards what? He turned towards seeking knowledge. He had that spirit. رحمه رحمة واسعة. His father, his granddad, and his great granddad, they were from the kibar ulama zamanihim. They were from the great scholars of their time. He, Ibn Atiyya, had brain, had sharpness, rahimahullah. He grounded and he mastered, فَأَتْقَنَ عُلُومَ اللُّغَةِ. He mastered the Arabic language, وَالنَّحُ. He mastered grammar. وَالْأَدَبْ. He mastered literature, the Arabic literature. وَالْفِقْ. He mastered fiqh. وَالْتَفْسِيرْ. He mastered tafsir. وَالْقِرَاءَاتِ. And he also mastered the qiraat. He's an imam, rahimahullah. ولذلك الحافظ ابن بشكوال he said about him كان أوسع واسع المعرفة. He said about him كان واسع المعرفة. That الإمام ابن عطية, his knowledge was vast. His knowledge was vast. واسع المعرفة. قوي الأدب. His manners and etiquette were good and his knowledge in literature was great as well. متفنن في العلوم. He was a person who you would say he's متفنن. متفنن means a person who has many sciences with him. أخذ الناس عنه, the people took from him. وكانت وفاته, and when he died, رحمه الله, was the year 541. And Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah praised Ibn Atiyah's tafsir and considered it to be from one of the best tafsir. His tafsir is called Al-Muharrar al-Wajiz fi tafsir al-Kitab al-Aziz. And it is from one of the ajallul athar al-ilmiyyah التي خلفها Ibn Atiyah. From one of the greatest works in tafsir that Ibn Atiyah rahimahullah left behind. And the people who've looked into his book and looked into his tafsir and observed it, they all unanimously agreed upon. قَدْ أَجْمَعَ أَهْلُ هَذَا الشَّعْنِ. The people who know tafsir, who know its sciences, they all agreed عَلَى أَنَّهُ غَايَةٌ فِي السِّحَةِ وَالدِّقَّةِ وَالتَّحْرِيرِ. That his book has reached a high level of authenticity, high level of diqqa and tahrir, how delicate his words are, the observation and how he speaks, and how he doesn't just bring a views, he makes sure he reads and he sees the views that are out there, how much they are, and he will mention it for you. This is tahrir. Say there are two views on this issue. This requires tahrir and tadqiq. It requires it. One of the things that he really gives consideration to in his tafsir is tafsir al-Qur'an bil-Qur'an. He really does that. He does that, rahimahullah ta'ala. One of the things that he's also great in, rahimahullah, is that he uses a lot al-ma'thur min al-ahadith al-sahihah. The ahadith which are authentically transmitted from the Prophet, he uses them in his tafsir. A lot. Shaykh al-Islam praised him for this, rahimahullah. He uses that. وَعَلَىٰ أَقْوَالِ الصَّحَابَةِ. He uses the statement of the companions a lot, and the tabi'een. And he gives importance to that. He also even brings, rahimahullah ta'ala, القراءات القرآنية المتواترة. He brings forward the ayat that have different recitation and different ways of reading it. From the qira'at which are mutawatirah, he brings them, rahimahullah. And he mentions any qira'ah which is not from the mutawatir, yubayinu wajhaha, he gives the wajh for it, and the reason why. And he clarifies if it's shad or not. And he goes in, rahimahullah. Again, his usage of the Arabic poetry and his usage of grammar is on another level, rahimahullah. He uses it a lot. He does istishhad of بِالشِّعْرِ وَيَهْتَمُّ بِالصَّنَاعَةِ النَّحْوِيَةِ. He gives a lot of importance to poetry, and he also gives a lot of importance to the صَنَاعَةِ النَّحْوِيَةِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Again, the way he explains the ayat and the wordings that he uses are بِأُسْلُوبٍ ثَلِثَةٍ. The way he speaks, the terms that he uses, everything, the way he says it, it is بِسَلَاسَةِ الْأُسْلُوبِ. The sloop, the method that he brings it, is not as... It's not like it's hard and you can see the person's overdoing it. So it flows the way he does it. Rahimahullah. Suhulatul ibarah. The wordings are very easy to read. He stays away from ghubud and ta'qid. Rahimahullah ta'ala. Rahmatan wasi'ah. Ibn Atiyah. So this is what Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah brings. Qurtubi quoting Ibn Atiyah. And Imam al-Qurtubi, he quoted Ibn Atiyah rahimahullah ta'ala. And who Ibn Atiyah was, he was 60 years, 59 to be precise, years before Al-Imam Qurtubi was born. Qurtubi was born 600, remember? And Ibn Atiyah died when? 500 and what? 41, right? Is it 59 years? Yeah? 59 years before Al-Imam al-Qurtubi was born. So, قال ابن عطية, Ibn Atiyah said, وَيَظْهَرُ لِي بِحُكْمِ أَلْفَاظِ الْآيَةِ أَنَّ الْمَرْأَةَ مَأْمُورَةٌ بِأَلَّا تُبْدِي. Ibn Atiyah says, what's apparent to me is, بِحُكْمِ أَلْفَاظِ الْآيَةِ, ruling and basing it on the wording of the verse, and that the woman is commanded بِأَلَّا تُبْدِي, that she should not show her adornment, وَأَن تَجْتَهِدَ فِي الْإِخْفَاء, that the woman tries hard, that the woman puts every effort in فِي الْإِخْفَاءِ, to hide herself, to cover herself, لِكُلِّ مَا هُوَ زِينَ, everything that's a beauty, she has to cover it. وَوَقَعَ الْإِسْتِثْنَاءُ فِي مَا يَظْهَرُ بِحُكْمِ ضَرُورَةِ, and the exception has happened and it has occurred, فِي مَا يَظْهَرُ, whatever becomes apparent, بِحُكْمِ ضَرُورَةٍ by necessity though. بِحُكْمِ ضَرُورَةِ حَرَكَةٍ when the woman moves and she does slight movements, whatever shows after she's covered herself up and she's made sure that her aura is covered, whatever shows after that movement, this is what's meant by it. فِيمَا لَا بُدَّ مِنْهُ which then is it's necessary that's going to happen. أو إِصْلَاحِ شَأْنٍ or rectification of a situation. She's moving or she's trying to do something, trying to rectify something, and then her aura shows. وَنَحْوِ ذَلِكَ and other than that, فِيمَا ظَهَرَ which shows عَلَى هَذَا الْوَجْهِ anything that shows in that way مِمَّا تُؤَدِّي إِلَيْهِ الضَّرُورَةِ فِي النِّسَاءِ فَهُوَ الْمَعْفُوُ عَنْ anything that shows from a woman out of necessity, meaning she falls, the wind takes her hijab up, or she's picking up something from somewhere, or and she's walking, or whatever it may be, he says this is what it's talking about. فَهُوَ الْمَعْفُوُ عَنُ then this she's forgiven for. This she's what? She's forgiven for. قال القرطبي رحمه الله الإمام القرطبي said قلت هذا قول حسن الإمام القرطبي said وابن عطية said is a very good statement. إلا أنه لما كان الغالب من الوجه والكفين ظهورهما but when the majority of the times إلا أنه لما كان الغالب except that the majority of the times the woman's face and the woman's hand it shows عادة it shows normally وعبادة and it also shows in what? Ibadah. Let's stop over here now. Sheikh Albani is bringing the statement of Imam al-Qurtubi. You need to understand why Sheikh Nasir wants to bring this. Qurtubi here is saying that what Ibn Atiyah said is good. No problem with that. But the majority of the times what shows from a woman, her face and her hands out of ibadah and aada. What does he mean by ibadah and aada? Ibadah, we get it in the salah. That when a woman is in the salah, her face and her hands show, majority of the times. What does he mean by adah? The adah here he means, and he's going to bring inshallah ta'ala, is the adah of the companions. That's what Al-Bani wants from that. That the adah of the companions was that the woman's face and her hands would show. Because who can restrict? What norms can restrict an ayah? I mean, what norms is the ayah applying to? Which adah can it apply to? Is the companion's adah. And the norms of the companions. Rahimahumullah. Rahimahumullah. وَذَلِكَ فِي الصَّلَاةِ وَالْحَجِّ So ibadah is in the salah and the hajj. فَيَصْلُحُ أَنْ يَكُونَ الْإِسْتِثْنَاءُ رَاجِعًا إِلَيْهِمَا So the istithna is good for it to go back to that. يَدُلُّ عَلَى ذَلِكَ مَا رَوَاهُ أَبُو دَاوُدَ عَنْ عَائِشَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهَا أن أسماء بنت أبي بكر رضي الله تعالى عنهما دخلت على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعليها ثياب رقاق فأعرض عنها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال لها يا أسماء إن المرأة إذا بلغت المحيضة لم يصلح أن يرى منها إلا هذا وأشار إلى وجهه وكفيه فهذا أقوى في جانب الاحتياط لمراعاة فساد الناس فلا تبدي المرأة من زينتها إلا ما ظهر من وجهها وكفيها والله الموفق والله الموفق لا رب سواه And the Aada, he brings the hadith of Asma that we spoke about, the hadith Abu Dawood narrated. That the Prophet ﷺ, he saw Asma bint Abi Bakr, رضي الله تعالى عنها. She entered upon the Prophet and she was wearing a clothing which was riqaq, very, very thin. فأعرض عنها, the Prophet turned away from her. وقال لها, the Prophet then said to her, يا أسماء أو أسماء, إن المرأة, the woman, إذا بلغت المحيضة, if the woman, she reaches her menses, meaning she reaches age of puberty, لم يصلح أن يرى منها إلا هذا. It is not permissible for it to be seen from her except this and this. وأشار إلى وجهه وكفيه. And the Prophet pointed towards his face and the hands. فهذا أقوى في جانب الاحتياط ولمراعاة فساد الناس فلا تبدي المرأة من زينتها إلا ما ظهر من وجهها وكفيها He says that القرطبي And this is the strongest in terms of safety in protecting yourself from the corruption that can come to you فلا تبدي المرأة to the woman should not show من زينتها her beauty إلا ما ظهر من وجه من وجهها وكفيها, except that which shows, which is her face and her hands. والله الموفق ولا رب سواه. Then Albani rahimullah, that's ta'aqib here. Sheikh Nasir, the issue of aadah is where he's going to go towards. I will leave that inshaAllah ta'ala for tomorrow بإذن الله الكريم. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaitan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.